Gina Carson. I have started a campaign for our kids in America, for saving our kids in America. And we are going to start with a prayer of breaking cigarette smoking and marijuana. So if you join me, and feel free to alter this prayer any way by filling any of the the spaces that will apply to you, like on the age, your name, and the circumstance. So, join me as I start praying and breaking off the nicotine and the smoking habit that our children in America are facing today, and all people are held bondage of. So I'm standing in the gap, as in Ezekiel 22:30, for our beloved people, for God's beloved people, as commissioned in the scriptures, that we are all set to go out, preach the gospel, and to educate the love of the Lord Jesus Christ into your hearts, soul, and mind, and bringing you to the feet of Jesus, and bringing you to the salvation of our Lord God Almighty. As the word says in Isaiah 55:11-12. And then as I pray that our Lord Jesus is the deliverer, and he will deliver you from this this sin, as in 1 John 1:7. So if you repeat after me, dear Jesus, I confess that at the age of 15, I started to smoke. And I confess that this is a sin. And I ask you for forgiveness, as I acknowledge that the sin has brought destruction into my temple, which belongs to you, of the Holy Spirit. I confess and break this rebellion and this kind of pleasure, which has brought destruction into my life and into my body. By the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, I break off the spirit of nicotine and any addictive spirits, and I command them to leave now. In Jesus' name, I ask for the cleansing of the blood of Jesus to cleanse my lungs, my bloodstream, and other organs from the smoking and the nicotine. And I thank you, Jesus, that you are making my body, you're healing my body. And I ask you to remove the way of this being a curse or a crush I ask you to remove the way of this being a curse and a crush of doing this sin, from holding something in my hand, from the cravings and the drug, as it acts as a comfort to me, that it may be also brought in from generational, from the generation curse from my ancestors, we break now. We break off the pleasure of feeling good and break off the anxiety and the rebellion that's behind it. So, Father, I ask that you remove this sin, and I ask that you remove every damage that was done to my body from doing this sin, from the deception of the enemy, who has lied to me and told me that this was a good thing to do. So, Father, I repent and I bring forgiveness. And I ask, Lord, that you restore my body, my temple, which is for you. Father, I thank you and acknowledge you as my King, my God, the Savior of my life. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So, I want to inform you that we are all commissioned, as the scriptures say in Mark 15:16, we are all called to minister the Word of God, to teach, and to share the good message across the world, across to our children here in America. So I encourage you to stand up and speak and save your kids. Pray for your kids. Pray for everyone who is held bondage in smoking and doing harm to their body. So I know that you know that I know that smoking brings a horrible odor to your clothes and to your breath. It also makes you overeat, and some people it makes them not eat. So we break off the fact, the lies and deception that you will be skinny if you smoke. That is the lie of the enemy, and we break that off also. We break off the fact that it's a comfort, that it's a praise, it's a pat on the back, that it pats you on the back, that you're doing good. That is also a lie from the enemy. So Father, we ask that you have the mind of Christ, and we ask that you will get into the scriptures and call unto you, Lord, as in Matthew 7:7, that anything that we ask our Lord, that he will give us if we believe. So I break off this lie, the deception from Satan that's held you bondage, and we break it off and set you free in the name of the Lord of Jesus Christ. And I thank you for joining me. And I'll see you next time. So Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we put on the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the girdle of truth, which is the truth, Lord. We've put on the shoes of the gospel of peace, that we may be able to stand on solid ground, Father. We put on the shield of faith, which quenches every fiery dart the enemy shoots our way. And Lord, we put on the sword, which is your word, Father, which is holy, which is wonderful, Father. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, which is power from the heavens. So, Father, we bless you, Lord, and we thank you for being with us as we go forth and break off the sin of smoking and the captivity of the bondage of tobacco. So thank you, Father, and I ask that your word will go forth, and we give you the glory, Jesus. Amen.